Hi, I'm Brennan from AWeber. In this video, I'm going to show you a six-step process to create your own automated email funnel that generates sales while you focus on other areas of your business. In this demonstration, I'm going to be using AWeber's powerfully simple landing pages, campaigns, automations, and e-commerce integrations. Plus, stick around to the end and I'll share a pro tip on how you can generate even more sales from your email marketing. Let's dive in. All right, our first step is to get subscribers into your funnel using a lead magnet or incentive. In this demonstration, we're going to be assuming the role of a food blogger, so our incentive or our lead magnet will be a PDF of our top 10 recipes. You'll need to host your lead magnet somewhere, whether it's on your website, or you can even attach your lead magnet to your first automated email in AWeber. So once you've got your lead magnet figured out, you're going to move on to the second step, which is to create a landing page where people can sign up to receive that lead magnet. So to do that, let's go over to the landing page builder in AWeber. And I've already created a landing page for the top 10 recipes. So I'm just going to go ahead and click through into this and show you a little bit more about what this landing page is all about. So this is done using one of our templates, the blog signup template, where you can easily drag and drop elements in, customize it how you'd like it. We've got a headline. We've got some description text in here that talks about the PDF and also says that they'll receive the weekly newsletter with recipes and tips for cooking healthy meals. And that's important for GDPR compliance so that you are providing them with, so you're clear on what you're going to be sending them in the future. Yes, you're going to be sending them this PDF, but you're also going to be communicating with them ongoing. So make sure to mention that in your signup form so that you're compliant with GDPR. Finally, let's go ahead and click on the form here. So if you click on the form and come over to your submissions tab in your controls, you'll notice that we're using a custom URL for the thank you page and the already subscribed page. And this is a custom URL for a thank you page that I built in the AWeber landing page builder, which we'll get to in the next step. Another really important thing to note here is that we are tagging subscribers when they sign up through this form with the tag top 10 recipes. And down here below, it will indicate what campaign will start when they get tagged with that. So you'll notice that when they get tagged with top 10 recipes, they're going to get started on the top 10 recipes campaign. So just make note of that. And this is an important step so that you're delivering the right campaign to your subscribers. All right, go ahead and save and exit. And we'll jump into the next step, which is to create a thank you page for your subscribers when they sign up. So I've got one created here already for the top 10 recipes. So let's go ahead and click through to that. And you'll notice in here that the main point of a thank you page is to thank them and let them know that their incentive that they signed up for is on the way, which we do right at the top here. My top 10 recipes are on the way. Check your inbox. You'll receive an email shortly. But the thank you page is a great place to talk about your products and services, to introduce them to what you have to offer, in addition to the incentive that you're providing them. So in this case, we're going to be promoting a cookbook. We're a food blog, so we're going to talk about this cookbook that we have for sale. And we've highlighted that this is a new subscribers only deal so that they feel special, they feel welcomed and important. So they can save 20% as a new subscriber by clicking this link here, which will take them to PayPal. And this is, let's talk really quickly about PayPal. So why PayPal? Well, there's a few integrations, e-commerce integrations that we recommend. PayPal is one of them. WooCommerce and Shopify are two others that we recommend because they have the most robust integration with AWeber. They support tagging, the ability to tag a subscriber when they make a purchase, not only generally, but also by the products that they purchase. They also allow you to do some cart abandonment campaigns, which is where we're going to get to a little bit later in the video. So it's important to use a platform that is robust and can connect well with AWeber. So this button clicks off to PayPal where they can make a purchase and buy the cookbook. Let's go ahead and save and exit. And the next step in this process, now that we have a thank you page, is to create a sales page where we're going to be sending subscribers to in the automated campaign, the automated email funnel that we're going to be sending them. So I've already got a sales page created for the cookbook. So let's go ahead and click and open that. I'll show you a little bit about that page. So similar to the thank you page, it's got information about this cookbook, the visuals, what's included in this cookbook, as well as the price. We've got buttons to purchase on PayPal And then down below, we've got some imagery that talks a little bit about some of the recipes that they're gonna find in this cookbook. I can probably add more to this page, such as quotes from people who have purchased it, reviews that we've received, and maybe additional information about what's inside. But I've kept it pretty straightforward here. So we've got a button to purchase up here. We've also got another button down below for those who scroll all the way down. And these again link off to PayPal where they can purchase this cookbook. So let's go ahead and save and exit. And really quickly, let me jump back to the thank you page. I forgot to mention this, but once you create your thank you page, you'll make sure to click the copy URL to clipboard and then go back to your main landing page so you can add that link into your custom thank you page field like I showed you earlier. And I've got a link to another video that we did on how to set up your thank you page and connect it to your opt-in page. So once you've created your sales page, let's jump back to where we are now. So we have just gone through creating a sales page. That was step four. The fifth step is to connect your e-commerce platform to your AWeber account. So if you're using PayPal, WooCommerce, or Shopify, just go ahead and connect those two. If you're not using one of those platforms, if you're using another e-commerce platform, it's highly likely that AWeber already integrates with it, may not have as deep of an integration and may not support tags like those three that I mentioned do. But we do integrate with many, many other applications out there. So I'm gonna drop a link to the in the description to our integrations page where you can check out all the different integrations that we have and definitely check that out. Another alternative is to use AWeber's page hit automation to tag your subscribers when they reach your order confirmation page, which you can have on your website, or you can even build an order confirmation page in AWeber using the landing page builder. So what that will allow you to do is tag a subscriber when they make a purchase and arrive at that confirmation page, whatever that may be. I'll include a link in the description of this video to show you how to do that, how to use the page hit automations. And then finally, once you've connected PayPal, WooCommerce, or Shopify to your AWeber account, you'll need to create an automation to tag your subscribers when they make a purchase. And that can be a general purchase as well as by the product that they offer. So if you offer a cookbook, for example, in this scenario, as well as other products, you can tag your subscribers based on the different products that they purchase and be able to personalize and customize the automated experience that you send them afterwards. I'll go ahead and drop a link in the description on how to set up that tag automation in your PayPal, WooCommerce, or Shopify account. All right, moving on to the sixth and final step is to build an automated campaign, an email campaign, to send to new subscribers, which not only delivers the top 10 recipe incentive that we're talking about, but also pitches them on the product or service that you have to offer. So to do that, let's go over to the messages and go to campaigns. I already have a campaign set up for the top 10 recipes, but it only has one email. It's that first email that delivers the recipe or delivers the incentive, the top 10 recipes. So what I'm gonna do is we're gonna add additional messages to this campaign. Just go ahead and click into this campaign. You'll notice that it starts on this tag, top 10 recipes. We've got it all set up ahead of time. We've got that first message. And all we're gonna do is we're gonna add additional messages that are gonna add value as well as pitch the cookbook that we have to offer. So what we'll do is we'll drag in a wait period here and then a message. So we've got a day difference here. And then our first message is going to be an added value message. So we're going to share with them our all-time favorite grilled lemon salmon recipe. So go ahead and select that one. We'll add in another one here for our next favorite breakfast for summer mornings. Go ahead and select that. And now we're gonna get into the emails where we're gonna begin pitching and talking about the cookbook or the product or services that you have to offer. So let's go ahead and drop in another wait period, another message. And our next message is going to be the 75 plus healthy meals your kids will love, which introduces them to the cookbook. All right, then we'll put another wait message in here and put another message down below it. And then we'll get into a more direct, you know, buy the Healthy Eats cookbook today and save 20%. Select that one. And then we'll go ahead and add another wait period to the bottom. And finally, another message and click the choose message. And finally, we'll do the last chance to save on the Healthy Eats cookbook. Select that one. Now we have 6 total emails in this campaign. 1 that delivers the incentive that we promised, 2 that add value, and then 3 at the end that really pitch very specifically the cookbook that we have to offer. Now, you can also add calls to action or links to your cookbook in the first 3, but don't make them the point or the focus of those messages. Just make sure that they are mentioned. You do mention that in the thank you page. So it does make sense to also include a link to it in these messages, in these first 3 messages as well. The last 3 messages really pitch specifically that cookbook. All right, and the last thing we wanna do before we jump out of this, let's go ahead and click on that and go to the campaign options here, is we're gonna add a subscriber automation. This is gonna remove a subscriber from this campaign when they get tagged with a particular tag. So remember step 5, we are tagging people when they make a purchase through PayPal, Shopify, or WooCommerce, or when they arrive at the order confirmation page using AWeber's page hit automations. We're gonna go ahead and put in cookbook as our tag and click apply, so that anytime anyone is tagged with cookbook, they're gonna be automatically removed from this campaign. Now the reason that's important is you've got all these emails that are pitching this cookbook, and if they go and make a purchase, you don't wanna continue pitching them the cookbook. So when they make that purchase through PayPal, Shopify, WooCommerce, or the page hit automations in AWeber, you'll go ahead and apply the cookbook tag, which will automatically remove them from this campaign so they don't continue to receive pitches on the cookbook that they've already purchased. Now we'll go ahead and save and exit this campaign. Now it's already active. We've got all of our messages in here that are pitching the cookbook as well as adding value. And now to the pro tip. If you're using PayPal, Shopify, WooCommerce, or AWeber's PageHit automations, you have the ability to send cart abandonment emails, which means that when a subscriber is going through the order process and doesn't complete it, you have the ability to tag them, send them an automated email, and bring them back to complete that purchase. I'll drop a link in the description on how to do that. That's it. Now you know how to build an automated email sales funnel in AWeber. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell to get notified when new videos are available. Thanks for watching.